really good to see everybody here. Thank you so much for your patience and flexibility. I know we were supposed to have this performance last Wednesday evening, but the faith had a different story for us. So here we are tonight. The beginning ensembles are truly something remarkable, and what these students do, it takes a special kid to come from all of the elementary schools to a middle school and a new experience and say, I want to do one more challenging thing. And all of the kids who are performing tonight have done that. They've decided that they wanted to take on something else that was challenging and put the extra time and energy and effort into learning something new. And we couldn't be happier with the progress that they've made, as you will see very shortly. So, to start the performance this evening, we're going to begin with our beginning orchestra under the direction of Mr. Sam Lyons.
Good evening. Good evening, everyone. My name is Mr. Lyons, Sam Lyons, and I'm the 6th through 12 orchestra director here at Timberlane. Super excited to present tonight's concerts. This is not only our first concert of the year, actually, but this is our first ever beginning 6th grade orchestra concert ever. So can we give that a round of applause? We are going to start with two different versions of an open string cycle. First one is going to be pizzicato, which means plucked with the string. We're going to play our open strings for you to demonstrate all of the ranges of the instruments. So you're going to hear our high violins, and you're going to hear our low viola and cello. Can you play your C string to show them your lowest string? Yeah, perfect. We're going to do pizzicato on the open string cycle, and then we're going to do a version of the open string cycle called blast off, which is with our bow. And what we did in the first month or two is we played only pizzicato, and then as we get better at our instruments, we did kind of like a little tiny test, and they earned little driver's license that allowed them to use their bows. So you're gonna hear blast off with the bow second. All right, here's our open string cycle.
All right, ready? Draw a bow over here. I'm gonna start with E, A, D, G, and then C. Ready? Here is E starting. One, two, ready, pluck E.
All within just a few months we're using that bow. They're doing amazing work. Our next few songs, Hot Cross Buns, Twinkle Twinkle, and Jingle Bells, are all going to include kind of both of those styles. So we're going to have pizzicato, which is plucked with our finger. We're also going to have something called colegno, which means with the back of the bow. And we're also going to have arco, which means with the bow. So our first piece is going to be hot cross buns. We're going to play it five different ways, five different ways of hot cross buns. We're going to start with pizzicato, colegno, then we're going to do arco on three different of our strings. We're going to use our A string, our D string, and then end on our favorite string. Our lowest string that we're using is the G string. Okay, here's hot cross buns. We're going to go into Twinkle Twinkle Little Star now. We're going to play this two ways. We are going to do it pizzicato, and then we're going to do it arco again. But this pizzicato is going to be a little bit different. It's actually going to feature a solo from each one of our amazing members of Beginning Orchestra. We're going to pass Twinkle around the whole orchestra. So here is Twinkle Twinkle, first with solos, and the second with arco all together. With our bow. Yeah, give a round of applause. Here it is, arco. Amazing. Ready, bow on the string. Big sound. One, two, ready. Thank you. We've got two more for you. We are going to do Jingle Bells. I think you might hear Jingle Bells again, too, because this is our winter concert. So I'm just going to go back to a little bit of holiday time for a second. We're going to play Jingle Bells, Pizzicato, and also enjoy Jingle Bells. Alright, we've got one more song for you. It's going to be Scotland's Burning. This is a traditional folk song. We're going to play just the melody of Scotland's Burning, and then we're actually going to do it around in three different parts. This is pretty brand new for us. This is kind of our first experience into playing different parts at different times. So not only have they been learning where to place their fingers on multiple different strings and using how to use a bow with a bow hold, but we're also starting to divide into different parts. So I think before we even play our last song, can you give them another round of applause for the progress they've made? It's a pleasure, true pleasure to be their teacher. And they've come so far in just a few months. So I'm really looking forward to what we have left this year. I'm looking forward to hearing the band as well. Just a couple thank yous to Mr. Schweiss for making this program also happen, Beginning Strings. So thank you to Mr. Schweiss. And here is Scotland's Burning, first, no round, second, three-part wrap. Thank you so much again.
Together. One, two, ready. To announce the sixth grade beginning band right up in front of us. Can we give another hand to the beginning orchestra as well? Thank you. This is such an exciting night that we get the chance to showcase off the skills that we've been working on since the beginning of the school year. Since this is their first time playing an instrument, some of them didn't know what they would like to play as soon as they walked into the classroom. So we did spend a few days kind of demonstrating and playing and experimenting on different instruments before we officially selected the ones that we're playing here on the stage right now. In that time, we've not only tried out the different instruments, we've learned how to put them together, and then the last thing that we had to do was learn to make a sound. So, I'm happy to say that we've been actually very successful with making our first few sounds on these instruments, especially within the first week of learning these instruments. For our first song we're going to play, it includes the first three notes that we played on our instruments at a slower speed. That way we all felt comfortable and successful at these notes. And this is called a half note rock. You will hear each of these pieces being played three times in a row. The first time will be played by just the woodwind group. The second time will be brass and percussion. And then the third time through with everyone here on the stage. This is half note rock. Separate them around and kind of do some skipping around. And in the process, we've had to learn how to read the notes as well. So this year, some people have been able to take off of that and really excel in that, and some people have been able to overcome challenges, and I'm happy to say that we're all being able to read out of the red book that we're using in class. And this next song is going to be Cuckoo, where we're going to be skipping around from note to note with the first three notes that we play. All right? we progress through our musical journey, we've now had to learn how to play some notes a little bit on the faster side. So our first few exercises included us playing these things called half notes and whole notes, where we hold them out for whether two beats or four beats in a song. Now we've kind of ventured into quarter notes, and we're now going to start to play this next song called Stepping Stone. She didn't come here just to hear me speak. So I'm going to get right into it. The next song is a great one that we've been working on. It's a song that added a few more notes and a little bit more jumping around. It actually was one of our most challenging songs we've started to play this year, besides our last piece today. But this next song is going to be Go Tell Aunt Rhody. So we're going to take the same five notes we've been playing, and we're going to play the next song is Merrily We Roll Along.
Thank you.
Queen's band class right here for our first concert. They did such a great job.
Before we play our final piece this evening, I would love to just do a couple thank yous just to make sure we show our appreciation for everything that they do for us. First, I would like to start by saying thank you to all of our building administrators for being so helpful and so supportive and making sure everything goes as smoothly as it can with a music program like this. And I would love to also throw in Mr. Kurt Schweiss with that as well. I would also like to thank Mr. Anthony DiBartolomeo for helping us with all of our tech and with all of our live streaming capabilities here. And lastly, I also want to thank each and every one of you for your support and helping inspire everyone to participate in music. I feel like especially in this day and age, we all need a little music in our world, and no place better to start than right now, as we can all say. For our final piece, we're going to end with the most challenging one that we've had to work with this year. And it's not an easy task to take an instrument, learn how to play it in your first year, and then now have to be independent in your part. This next piece is a well-known one, we just heard it earlier, Jingle Bells. But we're going to take Jingle Bells and we're going to make it into a two-part harmony. We're going to have some people playing the melody in the first part, and we're also going to have kind of a harmony happening in the beat. Here is Jingle Bells.